top-of-the-line energy weapons can be found. What can I do for you? It just so happens a position opened up recently. We currently need another body to guard the entrance outside. Think you can handle that? Wonderful. I already have a man outside who can show you the ropes and get you set up. His name is Simon. He's been with the family for years, so listen to what he says and follow his instructions.
Welcome to the Sylph. Aw, crap. Don't tell me you're my new guard. Well, no time for pleasantries. I've got your gear right here, but let's see if you can follow instructions. You'll be covering the other side of the door there. Take your position while I get your stuff out. Good. Look around and get a feel for what customers and risks are entering and exiting here. I'll get your gear ready. Okay, now let's get you geared up. First, your armor. The standard issue is your run-of-the-mill combat armor, with a nice dark coat of paint for both brand recognition and sheer intimidation value. Next, your weapon. Guards are required to use rifles. Anything lighter compromises your combat effectiveness.
Anything heavier and people are too scared to come in the door. What's your preference, laser or plasma?
Nothing wrong with going plasma. Just make sure you hit what you're aiming at. Now that you're equipped, a quick word on the job at hand. In a nutshell, we're here to keep the riffraff away. Drunks, punks, and capless vermin are to be turned away. Potential customers are to be permitted normal entrance. That is, after we pat them down for weapons. An unarmed man is a lot less likely to try to steal something with several armed guards around. Don't start any fights. I don't care if some jet junkie just assaulted your mother. We're here to promote violence elsewhere, not start it here. Lastly, don't abandon your post. We're getting paid to stand next to this door, not talk to someone down the street or head to the casino. That goes double for any thoughts of splitting with that gear. Every now and then, some young punk thinks he can run off with Van Grav property. Trust me, the rifle and armor are nice, but they're not worth your life. Other than that, relax. Who knows? You might attract a high roller from the Wrangler over there and never have to pull a gig like this again. Settle in. You've got some hours left before your shift ends. Here comes a winner. I'll let you handle this one.
Pick up a laser gun? Sounds like a stupid policy to me.
Good. Stick to the rules. Another one. You want. This I do not need today. This one's about to be interesting. Every day you love me less, each day I love you more. Yes, I've got heartaches, my number.
But today that I see. Hey, Simon, how's it hanging? Looks like you've got a little helper today.
What can I say?
Good to hear, buddy. The boss lady in. Now, I got some rounds to run, but do pass along. I'm always thinking of her. Actually, I got a better idea. Make the new hire tell her. You'll do that for me, won't you?
As I go riding merrily along.
I would, but I tend to distract the boss lady a little too much. She can't help herself. Anyway, I got things to do. Later, Simon.
There's hope for you yet. It's just about closing time. Let's go see the boss about getting paid. Oh, I'm gonna need the rifle and armor back. Boss's orders.
Hello.
Simon's been telling me how it went. Let's do a quick recap. You kept away the undesirables, patted down the rest for weapons, and kept your cool. That is to say, you performed as instructed. Simon was impressed, and so am I. So you get a small bonus with your normal pay. Unfortunately, I found someone else with a little more experience, and he'll take over the position starting tomorrow. However, another task has come up that I could use some help with, assuming you're still interested in making some money. There's a deal that we've been working on for a while now, and the buyer would like a sample of our weapons. I need you to run a package out to a discreet location that the client has chosen. Sound good? Good. Here's the package. I'll mark the location on your map. The buyer said they'd be in town for quite a while, so there's no rush. That said, try not to dawdle. This client could mean big money for us, which naturally means big money for you.
Hello?
Are you the Van Graaff's emissary? Do you have what we requested? I wasn't informed there was to be an exchange on my part. What are you talking about? Such a thing is possible. I've been out in the field for some time. Fine. This should cover your grievance. Now, the package, if you will. Then our business is concluded. Tell your superiors that we will contact them shortly.
Welcome back. Did you have news for me, or are you just here for the guns? And? Don't leave me in suspense. What was their reaction? Good. Good. Here's your payment. If you'll excuse me, I have some thinking to do. Oh, Jean-Baptiste was talking about a matter earlier that he needs help with. I volunteered you. See him for the details.
Ah, just the person I was looking for. Your name came up in a discussion we had recently. My sister is very impressed with you so far, but I'm not. I don't think you have what it takes to work for this family. Luckily for you, I'm going to give you a chance to prove me wrong. What do you say? Want to make some real money? All right then. If we're going to work together, there's only one thing you need to know about me. I like things simple. Recently, Glory negotiated a deal between us and a big-time player. We're talking more caps than you'd probably see in a lifetime. Your part in this is simple. To finalize this deal, I need to tie up a loose end. To do that, there's a girl I need you to find. Her name is Rose of Sharon Cassidy. That's some fancy shit, right? Don't know what her mother was thinking with a name like that. But this girl and I, we need to have a discussion. Find her. Bring her here so I can talk to her, one-on-one. You don't want us chatting, trust me. As for the girl, I just want to talk to her. And if you can't bring her here, then you're no use to me or Gloria. So if you want to cause trouble in here over nothing, then go on, try. Really? NCR all around her. Well, tell you what. You find a way to bring her here. She'll want to hear what I have to say. Find her, bring her back here so we can talk. Needless to say, there's some good money in it for you.
What's up? Why does everyone always say that? Okay, then I guess I'll be back at the 188. Maybe digging in some dirt for scrap metal or something.
You come around like a bad hat. With you? And why the hell would I do that? So fighting boredom is your argument, huh? Walking the Mojave with you can't be any worse than here, that's for sure. All right, I'm in.
No monorail accident.
Just Something's gotta give, something's gotta give. When an irrepressible smile such as yours warms an old implacable heart such as mine, don't say no, 'cause I insist. Somewhere, somehow, someone's gonna get kissed. So on guard, who knows what the fates have in store. From their vast, mysterious sky, I'll try hard, ignoring those lips I adore. But how long can anyone try? Fight, 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 fight it with all of our minds.
Just trim the Van Graaff family tree. I think Freeside will breathe a little easier now. Now, on to settle accounts with Alice McLafferty. Putting her down? That would suit me just fine. Can't wait to see the look on her face when I show up. She'll know why. Music to my ears. Let's distribute the weight.
To the town of Alfrey, who rode a stranger one fine day. Hardly spoke to folks around him, didn't have too much to say. No one dared to ask his business, no one dared to make a slip. The stranger there among them had a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. It was early in the morning when he rode into the town. He came riding from the south side, slowly looking.
All I'm doing is.
He's an outlaw, loose and running, came the whisper from each lip. And he's here to do.
Piss me
off.
Gonna six it.
In this town, there is. After Texas Red, after Texas Red. Wasn't long before the story was relayed to Texas Red. But the outlaw didn't worry, men that tried before were dead. 20 men had tried to take him, 20 men had made a slip. 21 would be the ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his heel. The morning passed so quickly, it was time for them to meet. It was 20 past 11 when they walked out in the street. In this town there lived an outlaw by the name of Texas Red. Many men had tried to take him, and that many men were dead. He was vicious and a killer, though a youth of 24. And the notches on his pistol numbered 1 in 19 bullets. 1 in 19 bullets. Now the stranger started talking, made it plain to folks around. Was an Arizona ranger, wouldn't be too long in town.
I think Lafferty's been riding asses again.
Welcome back.
Lay low.
After Texas Red. Wasn't long before the story.
story was relayed to Texas Red. Let's roll out then. Well, now that I'm free of the outpost, was wondering if you'd mind making a detour. I'd like to pay my respects to the end of Cassidy Caravans. Check out the site where they died. Upside of Vegas, here, Tal. Trapped at the Mojave outpost, so I wasn't able to run there when I heard. Been weeks since it was hit, so the site's probably a Cazador nest by now. Only wishful thinking on my part, most likely. At the least, I'd like to pay my respects. I got them into this mess. I owe them that much. Thanks. I appreciate it. Some of the caravan might be ash, but we were expecting raiders and over-inquisitive NCR border guards. There might be something left. If I'm there with you, shouldn't be hard to spot. And I'd prefer to see the bodies with my own eyes. All right, then. It was over in a moment, and the folks had gathered round. There before them lay the body of the outlaw on the ground. Almost nothing left. Looks like whoever it was just in the mood for killing. Most of the cargo's ash, too. Not burned, looks like disintegrated. When I heard the reports, I assumed ash meant burned. So close to the Vegas wall, too. Don't that beat all? Must have happened during the day, though. They hadn't made a camp. We should check the wagon. They may not have got everything. Whatever we find, it's yours. Least I can do for hoofing it all this way with me. You're just in time. You know what? What happened to my caravan? Not the first time I've heard about an attack like that. One of our caravans got hit a few months back, and the caravan been burned too, along with the cargo. I wonder if he made the same mistake, and that other caravan got hit with energy weapons too. Yeah, it's a ways though. Hell of a detour. You sure? All right, then. Let's move out. Energy weapons hit this caravan. Place has been picked clean. This is Brotherhood-level murder here. But they don't do things like that. This was done with a purpose. Let's poke around a bit, see what we can find. Might be something in the wreckage. Let's roll out then. What's that? Looks like a map. Got the route along the west of Vegas, and they've marked another spot. Over here along this stretch. That's fucked up. Middle of nowhere. Yeah. Something's wrong. I can feel it. It's not any closer than the first. So if you'd rather let be, let me know. All right then, let's move out. Careful where you flash that chip of yours. Not sure what kind of caps it's worth, but it's a tempting target. He came riding from the south side, slowly looking. Ask him then. I think we should explore the next one, see what's up. Got my curiosity riled. Another caravan burned, except someone made camp here, and I never heard about this attack. Let's look around. Something stinks. Many men had tried to take him, and that many men were dead. He was vicious and a killer, though a youth of 24. And the notches on his pistol numbered 1 in 19. That does it. That's all I need to know. Crimson Caravan and the Van Graaffs. They were behind burning these caravans, and they've got to answer for them. I'm gonna get some extra ammo, a few bottles of whiskey, and then show them how Cassidy's settle accounts. He came here to take an outlaw back alive or maybe dead. NCR? Are you out of your fucking mind? That'd take years. And with the war with the Legion, no way they're gonna waste time running up the Crimson Caravan or the Van Graaffs. But the outlaw didn't worry, men that tried before were dead. All right. If you poke around the Van Graaffs and Alice, fine. But if I see either one go into their camp, I'm gonna start shooting, no matter what you find. The morning passed so quickly, it was time for them to meet. It was 11:20 when they walked out in the street. Folks were watching from the window. Inside the Lucky 38. I'm not sure whether that's a blessing or a curse. Ask. If you're sure, you're lost. All right. Guess Vegas it is.
Some sugar. I, oh, of course I have, dearie. How silly of me. I didn't take my medicine yet today. How can I help you? Ooh, those night stalkers, always killing my big horners. It'll be nice to give them a piece of my mind.
Mm-hmm. There's me again, Mr. New Vegas, reminding you that you're nobody till somebody loves you. And that somebody is me. I've got news for you. Topps Hotel owner Benny has been killed by an unidentified assailant. His former right-hand man, Swank, consoled mourners.
If I know my pal Benny, he's swinging with the big cat upstairs as we speak. Or he's chasing some angel broad with cans as big as our Alo.
In other news, beef prices around the New Vegas Strip have dropped significantly following an agreement between the Ultralux and Brahman Baron Heck Gunderson. Those were our top stories. Gonna play a song for you right now, and it's about that special someone you find only once in a blue moon.
Is there something else I can do for you? There's still power, but the casing is cracked. I'm astonished that exposure to the stealth radiation could induce mutations so rapidly. More importantly, this explains why my research into this group of Night Stalkers hasn't come up with a cure for the Nightkin. There's only one avenue left for me. I need to run the Mark II test on Lily. It's the only way. I'll be waiting. Yes, I've got heartaches by
the number of love that I can. Heavens to Betsy, but Mr. Penny met a nasty end. I hope you've realized, Pumpkin, that crime doesn't pay.
Heartache number one was when you left me. I never knew.
Of course, dearie. I know it's dangerous, but it'll all turn out for the best. You'll see. I'll go to him now. It would be rude to keep him waiting.
You came back but never meant to stay. Yes, I've got heartaches by the number.
The equipment is hooked up and ready. We can start the test as soon as you give me the go-ahead. Very well. Please stand back. I don't want any erroneous readings. You're welcome to stay and observe if you want, though. All right, power on the stealth boy, Lily.
Turning it on. Feels strange. Strange, but good.
Interesting. Try thinking aggressive thoughts now. Think about smashing a rad scorpion.
Lily smash! Yeah!
How are those readings looking, Calamity?
Stealth field is unstable and scrambling things. The reading says gamma wave activity is zero, but that can't possibly be right.
All right, we're done here. Go ahead and power the stealth boy down, Lily.
Oh, I liked having it on.
I'll get back to you on that in a moment, once I've analyzed the results. Uh-oh.
Well, well, congratulations on getting the Mark II prototype functional, Doctor. Now, just hand it over, and we'll be on our way. My request is perfectly reasonable. Give us the stealth boy specs, and there will be no need for us to splatter the room with your insides. No, I didn't. Not until now, anyway. Very well, human. You've made your point, and I withdraw my request.
Nice work with the Nightkin. I've never seen anyone able to talk their kind out of anything once they had their mind set to it. I got a lot of useful data from the experiment, and am a lot closer to a cure than before. It's occurred to me that this brief test might not yield a cure anytime soon. However, if Lily were to continue to wear the prototype...
What do you need? Later.
Hey, no one but
me again. Mr. Nuve is reminding you that you're nobody till somebody loves you. And that's
hello, and welcome to Gamora.
I love you. More news for you. A source within the great gods.
I knew someone would call in that mark soon. What do you want to know?
And we'll support them in any conflict with Caesar's leader.
Sorry, they don't tell me their plan. All I can tell you is to find Caccino. He's the lowest level lieutenant you're going to be able to talk to. Some of the girls say he's been involved in some shady business the family wouldn't really like. Ask him about it.
Priority, and this move would not be unexpected. And that's the news. And now, I'd like to play one of my very favorite songs for you.
I hear you've been asking questions about me, dickweed. What the fuck do you want? Business? What the fuck do you mean, business? You looking to get yourself burned? Now you start talking real clear, and I mean fucking crystal clear, because I'm about to lose my patience. I don't give half a dick what you heard. Now get the fuck out of my face before I burn your sorry ass. They also brought in a specialist named Clandon. At least that's what they introduced him as.
Hey, nice to meet you. Do you need help with something?
Yes, I do. I love
Caccino. Yeah, I've heard the name. Not sure why he'd send you to me. Is he helping out with room service or something?
So be sure it's true.
Little bit of this and a little bit of that. I'm a close friend of some of the family around here. I do some independent contracting around the casino, and they set me up with this great room. Good to see you again. Hope you're winning some money in here.
There's some serious shit going on between NCO.
I love you. Yes, I love
you. Who are you? I didn't do anything. Leave me alone. Caccino? Caccino what? Are you kidding me? He must be trying to get me killed.
When you say I.
Yeah? Well, fuck that. The bosses have my number, and I'm a company man while they got the goods on me. I guess if Caccino trusts you, I can tell you a little of what happened. It all started with a prostitute in here. Oh, man. I don't even like to think about it. All that goddamn blood. It was just in the hotel like any other night. I took some Kims with the girl I was with, but I never black out. I did this time, though. Next thing I knew, I woke up, she was lying next to me, stabbed dead. There was a knife next to the bed, and I was covered in her blood. That night, mostly buff out. I like to cut it with a little bit of Jet and wash it down with some whiskey. That was my standard Saturday night. Well, Like I said, pretty standard for me. I can handle my shit. All right, have at it. I keep a little switchblade tucked away with me. You never know when you might find some trouble. All right, have at it. When I saw the body, I started screaming. In a few seconds, some of their soldiers were in there cleaning up the room. They offered to keep silent about what happened if I agreed to help them get their hands on large quantities of guns at deep discounts. What do you want to talk about? I don't see how that's your business. I'm just a guest here, having a little fun. Out of this world tonight. Yeah. You again. Make it quick. Make me Cappuccino. My sorrow. Yeah? Well, fuck that. So when I wake tomorrow, I'll know our love. More power to you if you can, but keep me out of it. I've been doing business with Big Saw, so he's going to be your man. Kiss me as though it were you again. Make it quick. Teach me all that a heart should know. Love me as though there were no tomorrow. My darling, love me. Don't ever.
Someone finally put. Good to see you again. Hope you're winning some money.
Cappuccino's friend. You got business with me? Ah, trike. What you want, some more jet?
Bosses don't like no trouble in their place.
You again. Make it quick. Holy shit. Really? Okay, I'll help you. But I'm getting the hell out of here first chance I get. They're keeping them in a little utility section down off the basement. I don't know what they're arming themselves for, but I know it isn't for the good of mankind. I'm pretty proud of myself. It's a stroke of genius if I could be so modest. The whole arrangement starts with an old buddy of mine in the Republic. He's responsible for packing and shipping supplies to the NCR on the Strip. He marks some containers as food and medical and packs them with guns and other shit. From there, it took just a couple of greased palms to get someone to let me cherry pick a container or two out of every shipment. Easy as pie. Okay, try and be fast about it. As a little pet project, I've been making some thermite. Thermite burns as hot as the devil's asshole and can melt through just about anything. I've been keeping it so if the family betrays me, I can hopefully do some damage before I end up dead or in jail. Hey, fuck you. All right, I'll place the fucking thermite myself. You get out of the casino for a bit. I'll take care of it while you're gone.